We're back. You know what time it is. So I played a little bit off camera because I was bored. But I didn't play much. I played like 5 minutes. All that happened is I went through this boring area and I came up here, but I got stuck. I don't know where I am. I don't know what I'm doing, and I don't know what I'm doing again. But now that I'm back here, we'll figure it out. Figure out a way to turn. Nope. What? How did that fix OBS? What the hell? Interesting. Now how do I get in there? I'm here. There's a little place up there that I've been before, but I'm not sure where to go besides that.
Spheres. I can't personally oversee every one of them, so these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts.
Anyway, that person that just talked was the founder of Aperture Science, also known as Cave Johnson. There's this other girl named Sean Michelle, something like that. I don't know. I forgot her name. Okay, now where am I going? Over here. Wait, never mind. I'm just here. I'm supposed to be flying. I see what I'm doing now. I'm just gonna like. Station. So it looks like green, blue gel. So this makes me from the blue gel to the green gel. It's a little bit awkward. Remember, that's just not my right mind.
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand-holding. All right, let's get started. This first test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs. Tragic, but informative. Or so I'm told. Just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day.
Well, I'm dead.
They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day. For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too. In case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
Well, great, then why would you experiment people on that then? It's quite pointless if it's gonna kill your subjects, ain't it? Whatever, it's science. It's science.
All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator, it makes a happy face.
Just like me.
Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
said, you know, COVID and stuff. Definitely not there. Okay, so it's supposed to go up. Wait a minute, am I supposed to go jump down? Oh, I see.
Just a heads up, that coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Does it actually?
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast. Telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Thank you.
always say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Hustle can use some work, though. Now let's solve this thing.
What did I just do? That's the cube. That's a bouncy cube. If I drop this, it will stop bouncing. This is not good. Oh, you get to wash it now. Okay, so if you splash it, it's just gonna... It's gonna be a bouncy cube. You need... Give me anything clean. So, to get this, you gotta pressure it here.
Dangerous? Why not marry safe science if you love it so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that won't hit you on the butt on the way out because you are fired? Now you test subject, you're doing fine. Yes, you, box your stuff, out the front door, parking lot, car, goodbye.
What? This is an automated, this is a recorded message. So he fired one of his employees.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there'll always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
Yeah, that's her. That was.
She is a gem.
I have a theory where Carolyn is GLaDoS. Glad Waverly. That's my guess. I'm not correct. I'm just saying, that's what I think. Now, where am I supposed to go? There. Somewhere now.
Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the parked benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope. Couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related.
So it looks like they picked up homeless people for their tests. Interesting. Door here.
If you're allergic to peanuts, you might want to tell somebody now, because this next test may turn your blood into peanut water for a few minutes. On the bright side, if we can make this happen, they're going to have to invent a new type of Nobel. All right, we're working on a little teleportation experiment. Now, this doesn't work with all skin. The average human male is about 60% water. As far as we're concerned, that's a little extravagant. So if you feel a bit dehydrated in this next test, that's normal. We're going to hit you with some jet engines and see if we can't get you down to 20 or 30%.
So this is like a small hidden door. Remember, if you see an orange jumpsuit, hit the red button.
Trick.
Sorry, it didn't work. Yeah. supposed to press that button. Heh? Excuse me, what now? Oh no, I'm supposed to go now. Up there. So you're just supposed to go put the fuck far. Interesting. So it looks like we're just gonna take GLaDoS with us, and we're gonna go hop. We're gonna go up to kill this little twerp. I'm gonna call him a twerp now.
Did anything happen while I was out?
The testing area is just up ahead. Really. The quicker you get through, the quicker you'll get your 60 bucks.
Good.
Carolyn, are the compensation vouchers ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson. Boy, did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here?
See, I told you guys. I told you. Caroline is going to play. Oh, speed. You and of course he's gonna be speed. So just like stars of mood. Hang on, go up there for a second.
6 volts. Now we know that. We just need to relax. We're still going to find out what the hell's going on here, but calmly.
So I got speed jump and jumping jump. Okay, I can click, add some to the wall there.
War hero and or Olympian, with your help, we're gonna
change the world.
This on? Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
Oh, wait, what? Oh, the logo change. Yeah, it's called Aperture. Just Aperture. Who is this guy, GLaDoS?
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let him know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your bindle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, then put you back together. Good as new.
Cube's going. Oh wait, it's right here. It's right here. Okay, so it's safe. I'm not gonna get any blue gel. Just leave this here. Let's have a look. Safe. Thank you.
case you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us.
Depending. Is it a success? Has it been a success before?
Or no? Or are you just testing on me again?
Well, alright.
Thank you! I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you had any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want old newspapers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy? Tattered hats? Beard dirt?
Make it across. Looks like you can't.
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. And the bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. And guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive. And do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills.
Oh, Mr. Johnson is sick. I just call him Mr. Johnson. Where am I supposed to throw this ridiculous gel? Okay.
life gives you lemons, don't make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life take the lemons back.
Yeah.
Get mad.
Yeah.
I don't want your damn lemons. What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Demand to see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day it thought it could give Cave Johnson lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's gonna burn your house down with the lemons. I'm gonna get my engineers to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down. Point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence, we should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm gonna say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. All right, test's over. You can head on back to your desk.
Goodbye, sir.
Well, does she know now who she really is? She's Carolyn. Well, I'm just gonna... going to die now. Try again. I'm supposed to be going somewhere all the way here. Wow. Made it. Dude, I'm so close. I feel like I'm gonna go up soon. How long have I been recording? Goddamn, 49 minutes. Alright, a little bit more, and if I feel like we're not gonna go anywhere, I'm gonna have to finish some recording.
I know things look bleak, but that crazy man down there was right. Let's not take these lemons. We are going to march right back upstairs and make him put me back in my body. And he'll probably kill us because he's incredibly powerful and I have no plan. Well, I'm not going to lie to you. The odds are 1,000,000 to 1 and that's with some generous rounding. Still though, let's get mad. If we're going to explode, let's at least explode with some dignity.
Yeah. Thank you.
this one. Because I've done way too many things. I'm tired. I'm like Cave Johnson now.